الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد الأمين نبي الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين، وعلى آله وصحابته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد، من قال: يحمل هذا الدين من كل جيل عدوله، ينفون عنه تحريف المحرفين وغلو الغالين وزيغ الزائغين، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم، إلى آخر الحديث الذي تلقته الأمة بالقبول.
بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam informed us that there will be in each generation of this ummah a group of upright, trustworthy people. There will be people who are upright and trustworthy. Forget about the word group. There will be people that the chosen, upright, trustworthy, knowledgeable people in every generation will ward away from this ummah.
ينفون عن تحريف المحرفين وغلو الغالين وزيغ الزائغين وانتحال المنتحلين أطواف الضلالة.
Right. Every generation they will cast away from this ummah the exaggerations of the people who are exaggerating, the changes that people attempt to change in the deen. There will be people who preserve the deen through this work of constantly brushing away from it the work of those who are corrupting it and changing it.
ومن أبرز هؤلاء في هذا القرن الماضي وفي هذا القرن الماضي وما مضى من هذا القرن الذي نحن فيه شيخ المشايخ شيخ شيوخنا وشيخ آبائنا العلامة المرابط الحاج بن السالك بن فحوة رحمه الله. من أبرز
And from the greatest of the champions of the truth and of the most known and agreed upon people who is did this, and this was the responsibility that they fulfilled. The sheikh of our fathers and the sheikh of our sheikhs, Sheikh Murabit al-Hajj, may Allah have mercy upon him.
فقد أعطاه الله سبحانه وتعالى من الهيبة والانتصار وانقياد العالم له وقبوله عليه مثل ما فعل بمالك في المدينة المنورة.
And Allah سبحانه وتعالى has given him such a
من الانتصار وانقياد الناس لها له وقبولها عليه وإتيانها له من كل حدب ونفس.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى has given him such a victory in his teachings and such a acceptance from the people that they came from all over the all the corners of the world, despite him being uncompromising, that they came from all the corners of the world in order to visit him from all around the world.
واسأل هذا المترجم قد مكث معه ساعة من الوقت ما لا حد.
And ask the translator. Ask the translator what happened in the brief. In the brief amount of time that he spent over there, what did he see? That there were people who were. That there were people from five different countries around the world who were visiting during that time. When you came to us visiting us in Mauritania, and you went to visit Murabit al-Hajj, what happened?
خلال ساعة أو ساعتين أتت طوائف شتى من شتى البلاد، خمس طوائف من خمس دول.
The people came from five different countries around the world. There were people who were visiting from five different countries during that time. Just that brief period of time. SubhanAllah.
تَتِ الطَّوَائِفُ لَوْ شَطَّ الْمَزَارُ بِهَا حَيْثُ الشُّرُوقُ وَحَيْثُ الشَّمْسُ قَدْ غَرُبَتْ كَمْ عُصْبَةٍ ضَرَبَتْ فِي الْأَرْضِ ذَاهِبَةً لِلشَّيْخِ وَاسْتَكْمَلَتْ عِلْمًا بِهِ انْقَلَبَتْ كَمْ مِنْ أُلُوفِ رِكَابٍ حَطَّ سَائِسُهَا لِلْعِلْمِ طَالِبَةً أَكْبَادُهَا ضُرِبَتْ كَمْ لَيْلَةٍ بَاتَهَا شَيْخُ الْمَشَايِخِ ذَا فِي سَهْرَةٍ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ قَدْ عَذُبَتْ تأتي القوافل لو شط المزار بها حيث الشروق وحيث الشمس قد غربت.
He said, the poet said in regard to describing the state of Murabit al-Hajj, that the groups have come, that the waves of visitors, have come from around the world, from all the way east to all the way west, cutting across the whole earth to come visit Sheikh Murabit.
كم عصبة ضربت في الأرض لاهبة للشيخ واستكملت علما به انقلبت. كم عصبة جماعات.
And how many large groups of people came from around the world and came to learn from him and benefit from him and went back with that علما به انقلبت
بثته في أنحاء البلاد.
And they took that knowledge from him.
استكملت كملت العلوم.
And they learned all of that knowledge from him. They finished their education with him, and they spread the knowledge from him all across the world. They went back and spread that knowledge back from all those places in the world where they came from.
كم من ألوف ركاب حط سائسها للعلم طالبة أكبادها ضربت. كم من ألوف ركاب.
How many thousands of vehicles and rides and mounts were taken? Cars, vehicles, planes, every type of vehicle.
حط سائسها قوادها.
That the drivers headed towards
وركابها.
And the passengers.
للعلم طالبة أكبادها ضربت.
Seeking knowledge, they rode those vehicles.
كم ليلة باتها شيخ المشايخ لا في سهرة بكتاب الله قد عذبت.
And how many nights did that sheikh of sheikhs spend in enjoyment and pleasure of the recitation of the book of Allah.
طلاب العلم يقرؤون عليه القرآن يتدبره ويفسره ويمتحنون فيه إلى آخر الليل.
The students of knowledge reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him throughout the whole night, and he is explaining it to them, giving them the tafsir of it, correcting their recitation.
في سهرة بكتاب الله قد علبت.
Enjoying and the pleasure of spending that night in the remembrance of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
عندنا من قبلنا من الذين درسوا معه قالوا لنا وأنا شاهد ما سأله سائل عن معنى آية من كتاب الله تعالى إلا وأجابها حسب ما في التفاسير بدون أي فكر له خاص.
And this is something that is known about him and was mentioned in regard to him, that there is no verse in the entire Quran that he is asked about except that he knows the tafsir of it and he would answer it.
من كتب الأقدمين قال فلان فيها كذا وكذا وكذا.
And he would say that such and such scholar said this and such scholar said this and so on and so forth about every single verse of the Quran, the meaning of it ingrained and memorized, the tafsir of it.
سئل الحسن البصري رحمه الله تعالى كيف يأتي الله تعالى بمثل عمر بن عبد العزيز في هذه الأيام يعني قال سبحانه كيف أتى الله في هذا الزمن الفاسد بعمر بن عبد العزيز.
So Hassan al-Basri, may Allah have mercy upon him, he was asked out of wonderment of how a person, he said, how does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring about a person such as Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz in such a corrupt time like this? Like in such a time like this?
انتشار الفتن ودعب بني أمية بالإمارة وسفك الدماء وشرب الخمور والمعازف والزانيات والقينات.
That all of the trials and the corruption and the people were getting all sorts of dunya and involving themselves in alcohol and in fornication and in musical instruments and dancing and so on, all of the types of temptations were being widespread and the types of corruptions that now that all the different false
aqidas
were being spread.
أيام عمر بن الخطاب يعني
and what was
ضبطا.
The means by which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought about such a person like Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz, who completely changed the face of the earth and changed the perspectives
حتى ردها على سيرة عمر بن الخطاب تامة بدون نقص.
And he restored justice within a short amount of time to return people back to the state of the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab without any deficiency.
بدون أي نقص. بدون أي نقص.
Without any deficiency, without
حتى
coming short
صارت
at all.
الذئاب تمشي على وجه الأرض لا تأكل الغنم. يعني خلاص.
That it was said he spread justice in the land so far that even the wild animals, the wolves would stopped attacking the sheep.
قال لا بد للزمان أن يتنفس. قال الحسن البصري جوابا لا بد للزمان أن يتنفس.
So then Hassan al-Basri, he said that this time...
كيف أتى الله بعمر بن عبد العزيز?
Answering the question, how does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring out in the midst of all this corruption a person like Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz? He said that the age has to breathe. كيف يعني?
لابدأ يتنفس يفتح الله فيه يتنفس يعني إذا لم يتنفس ستبقى الناس في ضيق تموت تختنق الهواء إذا اختنق على الناس ماذا يقع
لابد للزمان
للزمان أن يتنفس.
He said that basically this time has to breathe, the age has to breathe, otherwise people they'll die. People, all this choking that was taking place, there has to be a breath of fresh air. There has to be that breath, and which was Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz.
حتى يعطي الله للعالم الإسلامي تنفسا روحا إنسانيا روحا إسلامية روحا دينية خلال هذا الرجل.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed the people, the whole world to breathe a sigh of relief, to breathe to smell not the fresh air, but to smell the fragrance of paradise. To take the path of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and of the righteous guided khalifas from him.
كذلك قال الناس عندما سئل عن مراد الحج قالوا هو عمر بن عبد زمانه.
That when people asked about Murabit al-Hajj, Murabit al-Hajj was described as the Umar of his time or the Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz of his time.
جاء إلى شقيطة في أيام ظهرت فيها أنواع من الفساد بل عم العالم حقيقة من أصحاب المتصوفة ومن أصحاب الطرق والمجسمة وأدعياء العلم والسياسات والحكومات الظالمة والجور في وقت إنما هو أيام عمر بن عبد العزيز.
That he was born in Mauritania at وهر. The time that he was actually نعم.
ظهر بصلاحه وعلمه. جاء إلى الناس.
So he came to Mauritania at a time that.
لما عاد من الحج.
When he came back from Hajj, he came to a Mauritania at the time that was filled with corruption
and ignorance.
All sorts of misguided groups and sects. People who are likening Allah to His creation. People who are the Sufis who invent all types of new nonsense in the deen. Politicians were being, politics was being, subhanAllah, in a very sensitive state of compromise. That this the political ideas and agendas were widespread. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought to the world and to Mauritania at the time such an individual that changed the face of the landscape for everyone and changed the whole entire world. That all he's looking at is the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
لا يصرفه عن ذلك عالم ولا صاحب جاهة ولا سياسي. لا.
And no one who is called a scholar or a community leader
أو قاضي أو حاكم لا أو رئيس لا.
Or any leader or any world leader or any politician or any judge or any scholar, nobody averted his gaze from the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
عنده نظرة واحدة هي مشاهدة رب العالمين.
He's keeping his sights on one thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. He's paying attention to one thing that Allah is watching me.
قيل لبعض العقلاء لماذا المرابط الحاج جاء الأمير أمير تقانت عبد الرحمن بن سويد أحمد وهذا كان أميرا مثل يعني أمير كامل يعني جاء إلى قالوا قيل له لماذا لا يأتي المرابط الحاج إليه أمير
so the leader of the region called Taganet, his region, he came to the city where Murabit al-Hajj was, called Geru.
وتداعت عليه الناس كلها علماء وأشراف وأصحاب جاه.
And since he's the leader of the entire region, that everybody came, all the community leaders, all the scholars, all the everybody
كل الناس بطبقاتها.
All the different strata of people.
ما فقدوا إلا المرابط الحاج.
Came to him, but the only one who was missing was Murabit al-Hajj.
فلما فرغ الأمير من زيارته لجرو وأصحاب الجهات ذهب إلى المرابط الحاج ليزوره.
So then once that leader, he was done dealing with all of these masses and all of these people and the scholars and so on, he himself, he went to Murabit al-Hajj to visit him.
فقال أحد أبنائه الأمير لأحد أبناء عمومة المرابط الحاج وقال له أحمد بن الشيخ كان عاقلا قال ما الذي منع المرابط الحاج من يزور عبد الرحمن.
So then one of the sons of that leader, he said that why didn't Murabit al-Hajj visit our father, يعني.
فأجابه قال المرابط الحاج لا يرى غير ربي.
من أجابه؟
أجابه ابن عم المرابط الحاج وكان عاقلا هو المسؤول.
So the cousin, he said this to the cousin of Murabit al-Hajj. He said, why didn't Murabit al-Hajj come
with
everybody else?
من الذي منع؟ متعجب، هو متعجب. قال
what stopped himself? He was confused. Why everybody was going to my father? He's the leader. Why didn't Murabit al-Hajj go? My father came to him. He said,
المرابط الحاج لا يرى غير ربي.
The response of the cousin of Murabit al-Hajj was, المرابط الحاج does not see anyone. He only sees his Lord.
لا يرى مقاما غير مقام المشاهدة.
His sights are set upon this maqam of mushahada that I am witnessing that Allah.
هذا الأوزاعي، هذا الأوزاعي، هذا ليس المرابط الحاج، هذا ليس إجابكم، هذا الإمام الأوزاعي. هذا الإمام الأوزاعي.
That Allah is watching me, Allah is observing me. That's the only thing that I'm observing. This fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watchful over me.
هذا الأوزاعي.
As if I see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of me.
هذا الأوزاعي، هذا الإمام الأوزاعي.
So this was مرابط الحاج's state was the state of Imam al-Awza'i.
لو قيل للأوزاعي إنك تموت غدا ما قدم عملا زائدا على ما كان عليه.
And the state that al-Awza'i was known for is that if he was told you're going to die tomorrow,
ما قدر على زيادة أي عمل مطلقا.
He wouldn't change anything of his actions. Why? Because there's no way he could add more righteousness to his schedule, to his
من
day.
هو على هذا المقام هذا ببارد الترم.
His actions were such that it was impossible to adjust them to closer to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a better way. And subhanAllah, somebody who is in this state, is this going to be the person who is going towards Trump and working for Trump?
هل يبالي بزيارة ترامب أو كلينتون أو رئيس فرنسا أو رئيس السعودية؟ هل يبالي بهؤلاء؟
Is the person who is focused on Allah going to care that Trump is visiting
الله أمامه
and seeing Allah in front of him that Trump came to him or the leader of Saudi Arabia or Emirat came to him?
أنا لما كنت هنا في بئريا قبل 17 سنة جئت هنا في سنة 2002 18 مهم يعني.
So 18 years ago I came here in the year 2002 to the Bay Area.
ولما وصلت هنا كنت ألقي دروسا في الزيتونة القديمة، معهد الزيتونة القديمة، معهد الزيتونة ليست الجامعة.
That I came here about 18 years ago and I was teaching classes in the Zaytuna Institute before it was the Zaytuna Liberal Arts College. The Zaytuna Institute, which of the reforming of traditional
old Zaytuna, قديم,
the Zaytuna old Zaytuna, as people call it.
نعم. The ناس كانوا في جلسة وكانوا متعجبين. قالوا جاء الشيخ فلان وجاء الشيخ فلان يعني عبد الله بن أبي وغيره. وقالوا يا عجبا يا عجبا يا عجبا.
نعم.
قال إن الشيخ فلان والشيخ فلان تعجبوا من حال المرابط الحاج لأنهم جاءوا وقالوا الناس كم أخذت من وزارة وكم أخذت من سفارة ولم يبلغ صيتها هذا المكان. ولما وصلنا إلى فإذا هي الناس تتحدث عن مرابط الحاج والكمبيوترات مملوءة بصوره والناس كأنهم يعيشون أمام المرابط الحاج. يعني الناس تعجبوا قالوا سبحان الله كعبد الله بن أبي وغيره.
نعم.
لما زاروا تلك السنين
So in those years, people such as Abdullah ibn Ubayya
قالوا للناس إنهم تعجب الناس من له من عبد الله بن أبي وغيره إنهم تعجبوا من شهرة المرابط الحاج في العالم.
That they said that they were surprised to see how famous.
لما جاءوا هنا لسان فرسك وخلي السفر.
When they came here to visit, they were surprised to see how
شهرة المرابط الحاج بين الناس.
مرابط الحاج was
لا تجد أحد إلا في كمبيوتر صورة المرابط الحاج.
That you see everybody in their pictures and their profile pictures and in their computer.
والناس يتكلمون ويعطون محاضرات عنه.
And there's people speaking about him all the time and giving speeches about him.
فقالوا سبحان الله الناس كم أخذت من وزارة وكم أخذت من مقام سفير وما وصلت إلى هذا المعنى.
And they said سبحان الله how many people they strove after this fame or striving to get this fame by becoming ambassadors and judges and leaders and so on and they did not reach
a fraction.
And they did not reach a fraction of this type of fame.
فأجبتهم جوابا نصف العين هذا واضح جدا.
So I answered them a very obvious answer, a very clear answer.
قلت لهم من سفيره جبريل هو كسفير فرنسا أو أمريكا.
I said the one who his ambassador is Jibril. Is he like the one whose ambassador is an American or a French guy? Or
ما عجبكم بالغرب؟
How are you so impressed by the West?
ما شاء الله ما أعظم الغرب في أعينكم.
How great is the West obviously in your eyes?
ألا تسمعون قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ ألا تسمعون قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
Have you not heard what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said?
إن الله إذا أحب عبده أمر جبريل ماذا يقول؟
Once Allah loves His servant, He commands Jibril. What does He
يقول,
say?
يا جبريل إني أحببت عبدي.
He says, "Oh Jibril, I have loved this servant of mine."
أخبر أهل السماء أني أحبه.
So love him and command the people of the heavens to love him.
ثم ينشر له القبول في الأرض.
And then his love and acceptance is spread throughout the earth.
ينشر له القبول في الأرض بسفارة جبريل عليه السلام.
The acceptance of him is spread throughout the earth through which ambassador Jibril عليه السلام. Love and acceptance is spread throughout the earth for him.
سفارة جبريل.
Jibril is the ambassador.
تعرفون ما هو خلق جبريل؟
Do you know how Jibril, what his being
is
like? When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw Jibril in his actual image, that he filled the entire horizon. All the universe, all the sky was filled. And there was nothing in the distance but Jibril. That you couldn't see any direction except to Jibril. Does America fill the horizon?
نعم سدت عقولكم ولكن ما سدت الأفق. الأمريكا سدت الأفق كله. نعم سدت عقولكم.
No, it has filled your minds.
سدت نعم أنا أخبركم سدت عقولكم. أغبياء.
I'll tell you.
يا أغبياء سدت أمريكا عقولكم أما جبريل فسد الأفق.
I'll tell you.
يا أغبياء. ترجم.
نعم. I'll tell you, oh fools. That it has not filled the horizon, but it has filled your minds.
America سدت أدمغتكم.
It has filled your brains.
فقتلوا شتان ما بين من جبريل سفيره وبين من فرنسا وأمريكا سفراء.
So my response was very simple. How far are they? Different worlds apart.
Their
worlds apart. When he was asking, how did Murabit al-Hajj become so famous? They thought I was going to say, oh, wow, that's so, subhanAllah, that's so amazing. I said, obviously, the one who his ambassador is Jibril is not like the one who's... The Jibril, if Jibril is the one who is spreading the... You know, the acceptance for this person. Meaning that Murabit al-Hajj is working and focused on pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's not working for some government. So the fame that you achieve and the acceptance in the land that you achieve by aiming to please Allah and putting only Allah's pleasure in your sights, that it cannot be comparable to the one who strives to gain acceptance and honor through pleasing the creation or by association to non-Muslim governments or even any Muslim government or any human being or creation of Allah.
هذه الشخصية العجيبة التي أبرزها الله تعالى كما أخذت من أبي رحمه الله تعالى كنت ذات يوم معه وأنا في السادسة من عمره السابعة سمعت يقول المراد الحاج كأبي بكر الصديق. هذه الشخصية التي تداولت العقلاء والصالحون يعني تمثيلها بالصحابة أو بعمر بن عبد العزيز وغير ذلك كيف هي تغيرت.
So then the topic is this personality, this great personality of Murabit al-Hajj. How did it develop? How did he come about?
صار يمثل بأبي بكر الصديق.
How did he become who he was?
عمر بن عبد العزيز.
How did he become who he was? That people are comparing him to the companions. People are comparing him to Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. Even my own father, I remember when I was 6 or 7 years old that I was with him, that he said Murabit al-Hajj is like the modern day Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. So subhanAllah, what transformed? Such an individual, what made him the way that he was? This was something that I pondered about for a long time and I couldn't quite understand what made him who he was.
فلما كان قبل زمانية 16 سنة 17 سنة كنت أقرأ تاريخ خلفاء الراشدين كنت أدرسه للناس.
So then
17 سنة تقريبا
قبل 17
سنة نعم من لدو 17 سنة.
So about 16-17 years ago I was
أدرس تاريخ الخلفاء الراشدين.
I was teaching the history of the guided khalifas.
فإذا هو من مناقب أبي بكر أن معاوية بن أبي سفيان رضي الله تعالى جميع قال أما أبو بكر فلم تلد الدنيا ولم يلدها.
And then I was looking at their biographies and I was teaching them, and then I came across something, subhanAllah, that caught my attention and answered my question, that in regard to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, what was his description by Abu Sufyan?
Muawiyah ibn Abi
Sufyan. May Allah be pleased with them both. He said, with all of them, he said that as for Abu Bakr, he's an individual that the world did not want him and he did not want the world. And this is the starting point, the foundation of
Murad.
He did not. He rejected the people. He did not want the people at all.
لا يريدهم وما لا يريدونه خذوا لأن الوقت في ذلك الوقت منهجه لا يقبله أحد أصلا.
Because in the beginning of his time, nobody was accepting his methodology at all.
He did not want the people. وبعده عن الدنيا ومنهجه الصحيح غير مقبول أصلا.
His way of leaving the people and abandoning the people, this was so strange to them. Nobody accepted this. This was just considered so foreign and so
weird. وهو لا يفكر عنه.
But he didn't care what people thought at all.
سبحانه فهمت الأمر. لذلك الوقت قبل تقريبا 17 سنة فهمت الأمر.
In that time, about 17 years ago, I understood. I finally understood. It took me about 30 years.
لذلك الوقت عمري 30 سنة. سبحان الله.
It took me about 30 years to understand. At that time, I was actually about 30 years old.
يعني أخذ مني كم من العمر.
That means it took me so long to understand. Now I understand. Now I understand. Of course, the virtue of Abu Bakr himself, that is something that nobody can achieve. But I was amazed how my father could liken Murabit al-Hajj to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. But now I understood what it meant.
هذا معروف عند موريتانيا عندهم عند عوامهم ولكن أنا أخبركم بالسند الصحيح. أنا أخبرني منان بن أحمد للطيب أحد تلامذة المرابط الحاج أنه أخبره زميله الذي كان يدرس معه هو المرابط الحاج الشيخ محمد محمود محمد يحضي.
الأسماء صعبة علي.
هذا واضح ومنان هو شخصين.
نعم نعم.
أخبرني منان أنا أخبر هذا معروف قصة
so تغيري. The story of the transformation.
هذا معروف.
Of Murabit al-Hajj is well known, but I'll tell you actually with along with the chain of narration of who told it to me from Murabit al-Hajj, there's two people between me and Murabit al-Hajj in this story. The first one is called Mannan, the
one who told me this Muhammad bin al-Tayyib, Sharif, bin Ali Bayt
Rasul. Mannan ibn Muhammad ibn al-Tayyib, he is a Sharif, he is a descendant of the Prophet
وكان من تلامذة المرابط الحاج الأولين ومحبين له ومن أقران أمي من معاصرين أمي.
And he is,
حيا يزورني الآن في البيت.
And he is still alive right now, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him. And he's one of the earliest students of Murabit al-Hajj from the first generation of students at the same time as my mother.
قال نقلت عن زميله الشيخ محمد محمود بن محمد يحضي أحد علماء موريتانيا الوريعين.
So he said he learned from his
نقلت سمعت.
He said I heard from one of the my, his peers called Muhammad Mahmoud.
كانوا معه في المدرسة.
Who was with him in that school. He is one of his peers.
معاصريه معناه مثله في العمر.
Peers يعني هذا يعني.
نعم. وكانوا عند أحمد المرابط أحمد بن أبات شيخ المرابط الحاج والشيخ الرجل الآخر.
So peer means like fellow student, a person who's studying at the same time as you. So then he said that he heard.
قال كنا أنا والمرابط الحاج في محضرتي المرابط أحمد بن عباد.
So he said me and Murabit al-Hajj
وغيرنا من طلاب العلم
and the other students of knowledge were at the
أحمد بن عباد
were with Murabit al-Hajj at the school of Muhammad ibn Abbad
أحمد بن محمد بن عباد
أحمد بن محمد بن عباد
هذه محضرة كانت هي أشهر محضرة في موريتانيا
and this was
أشهر محضرة في موريتانيا
And this was the most famous school in all of Mauritania at the time.
محضرة وكان من لم يدرس فيها كانه ما درس في تلك المنطقة تقان.
And then the one who did not study in that school and in that region, it's as if he didn't study anywhere.
قال كان المرابط الحاج لا يتركنا مزاحه هنا من كثرة ضحكه ومزاحه في ذلك الوقت.
That he said in that time.
قال الشيخ محمد محمود بن الحضي العالم الورع.
The great scholar Muhammad Mahmoud ibn
Muhammad الحضي قال كنا في ذلك الوقت.
He said at that time we were with Murabit al-Hajj in that school of Ahmed ibn Muhammad ibn Abbad.
أحمد بن محمد بن عباد لا يتركنا مزاح بطر يقول وبطر كمثل الأقران معناها ضحكه ولعبه.
He said that Subhanallah Murabit al-Hajj he was known to be a jokester. He would always be joking around with people. He was a great genius. So then he was very funny. He was very comedic. That we couldn't even sleep because of all of the joking around and laughing. So what changed his state of being? That their sheikh was a very famous sheikh.
عالم مقبولا في البلاد من لم يدرس عليه كأنه ما درس.
And he was such a famous sheikh, and of course he was the descendant of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And whoever didn't study with him, it was as if they didn't study.
صلى بهم العشاء.
He prayed عشاء. He led them in عشاء.
إماما. ولدغت حية وتوفي ودفن من مقابر قبل الفجر.
And لحظة بس شيخ.
لا يتركهم بطر المرابط الحاج ينامون كما يقولون.
That as he said that Sheikh Murabit al-Hajj was so joking around and they were in such having such
شاب ذكي من أهل القرآن عراب خبير بالنحو يعني مضحك.
That he was mashallah very eloquent and very knowledgeable, very smart, and he was very funny, and they would just stay up laughing and joking around.
لا يتركنا ننام.
He said we couldn't even sleep at night. We'd stay up late
وكان
every
أحمد
night.
بن عباد رجلا عالما مشهورا في البلاد ارتفع صيته في عامة المعمورة.
And the sheikh that they were studying with Muhammad ibn Abbad, he was Ahmed ibn Muhammad ibn Abbad. He was very knowledgeable, and his fame and his knowledge and
صلى بهم صلاة العشاء.
He said that day he led them in عشاء prayer.
وعضته حية وتوفي ودفن في المقابر قبل الفجر.
And he was bitten by a snake. And he was buried, and he died, and he was buried in the cemetery before Fajr even. When Murabit al-Hajj saw just how quickly the state changed, then he changed his methodology right away. That day. From that day, he immediately transformed and was never the same again. The path of Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad.
Ana laka ya murabit an tantaqila min ad-dunya. Qal hadhihi ad-dunya la tusawi shay'an aslan. Ahmed al-Barih al-murabit Ahmed salla bina al-isha wal yawma fi al-qubur.
That he saw the valuelessness of this world. He said, "Oh Murabit,
hadhihi ad-dunya la tusawi shay'an."
This world is worth nothing. Just yesterday
Murabit Ahmed ibn Abbas salla bina al-isha al-Barihah.
Just yesterday, in Murabit Ahmed ibn Muhammad ibn Abbad, he led us in
Isha
just last night, and just now he's in the cemetery. That's what this world is like. That's it. We're done. I divorce you, O world. That's it. We're finished. And because of that, what would he say? In the poetry that he would say, admonishing himself, he would tell his self, O self, rise and be admonished.
وانزجري وفجأة الحمام كمثل ما وقع على شيخ.
And be prepared for the sudden departure.
فاحذري لا تأتي كبرت الظفنة. أنت كنت بطيرة.
Beware of thee.
أنت كنت بطيرة.
You are involved in this mirth and heedlessness.
أما ترين شيخك انتقل البارحة.
Have you not seen your sheikh has passed away last night?
وقد بلغ ما بلغ.
And he reached the status that he had reached.
انزجري. ولذة الدنا جميعا فهجري. خلاص انتهى الأمر.
Turn away.
لذة الدنا جميعا.
All of the pleasures of this world, abandon.
الضحك ومخالطة الناس والأطعمة انتهت الآن خلاص.
Laughing, joking, mixing with the people, enjoying different foods. That's all done.
انتهى الأمر.
All done.
ولا سيما الهجوع وقت السحر. لا سيما النوم وقت آخر الليل هذا خطير.
And forget about sleeping in the last third of the night. That's the time for prayer.
ولعبادة العلي شمري إياك والإكثار من الغرر. خلاص. شمري.
And for the worship of the exalted, roll up your sleeves.
ولذلك يقولون موت أحمد بن أبات أصلحت المراط الحاش.
Get ready for that. So they say, as a result of this story, the death of the passing of المرابط أحمد بن محمد بن أبات
أصلحت المرابط
it is
أصلح الله بها أمة إسلامية كاملة.
That incident Allah سبحانه وتعالى used it as the means of the transformation, the reformation of مرابط الحاج and of this entire ummah.
ترك الدنيا وخلاص.
He left
كأنه الفضيل بن عيار. الفضيل بن عيار.
He abandoned this world at that moment as if he was Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad.
الناس هذا الناس التي أراد الله بها العناية تتغير بأشياء عادية.
So these people, what does this show us? These people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses their guidance and goodness for them, then
تتغير بأشياء يعني عادية. نحن مسكين لا نعدها شيء لا نعدها شيء.
It doesn't take much to change them. They just are nudged in the right direction with the simplest things.
رؤيا يعني.
With the simplest things, once they experience the truth, they experience, they wake up, they have a moment where they realize that's all it takes. Maybe it's the death of their sheikh, like Marabat al-Hajj. Maybe it's the death of a friend of theirs. Maybe it's a true dream that a righteous person had or that they had. That's it. That's all they need.
يعني.
Or something that they were reading in the Quran that stood out for them.
فتغير حياته من لصوصية إلى صحابية. كأنك صحابي تشاهد الوحي.
And it changes their status from being a criminal to as if they are a companion that is witnessing. Subhanallah, Sheikh, شيء عجيب جدا حدث لي قبل أن أتيت بعد الظهر تأخرت شخص قال لي لابد أن أكلمك اليوم قبل أن آتي. سبحان الله. وهو قد أسلم من زمان. قال أنت لا ربما لا تعرفني ولا تعرف قصتي ولكنني أسلمت. وبعد أن أسلمت فعلت أحد الكبائر وبدأ يبكي لا يستطيع أن يقول لي ماذا حدث.
كم أعلم ليست كبيرة واحد يقول لي كل الكبائر.
قال أنني سمعت ذكر التوبة ويعني كيف يعني مقام يعني أعوذ بالله الفاسدين الظالمين. فقال يبكي قال ماذا أفعل أنا فعلت كبيرة قبل ممكن 4 سنوات 5 سنوات بعد أن
سيكون فعلها مليار مرة.
نعم. فقال فكان يبكي قال كيف ماذا أفعل.
توب إلى الله تعالى عادي الأمر سهل.
نعم. قلت له توب وتعلم ولكن سبحان الله كان شيء صغير جدا.
نعم هذا يبكي يعني. إذا أراد الله عناية خلاص قل لهم.
سبحان الله. So even before here it's interesting that the Sheikh is saying this because literally today before after Dhuhr I leave and it's an hour drive to come here and subhanallah after the prayer one person pulled me to the side and he said and he said I need to talk to you. When he came to talk he couldn't talk, he just was crying and I said what happened. He said subhanallah he was crying over a sin that he did 4 years ago or 5 years ago crying. And what happened? Nothing happened to him. Now things are fine. Things are good. It just, subhanAllah, he had a realization. He heard something about tawbah and about sinfulness and oppression and so on. And he was crying over a sin that he did 4 years ago. He said, what do I do?
توب إلى الله.
Repent to Allah subhanAllah. هذه. It's easy.
قد تكون المرابط الحاج ثاني.
You could be the next مرابط الحاج.
قد تكون الفضيل بن عياض.
You could be the next فضيل بن عياض.
الفضيل بن عياض ما حدث له.
What happened to Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad?
Fudayl ibn Iyad كان لصا. كان لصا يتسلق البيوت.
That he was a robber, he was a thief. He would break into houses.
فكان على سقف بيت ومباشرة سمع قارئا يقول قول الله تعالى ألم يأني للذين آمنوا أن تخشع قلوبهم لذكر الله وما نزل من الحق.
He was climbing a house. He was on top of the house that he was going to rob, and he heard somebody reciting, "Isn't it about the verse that Allah says, close meaning of, isn't it about time for the believers' hearts? Isn't it about time for the believers' hearts to soften and humble themselves to the remembrance of Allah and that which is revealed of the truth? Isn't it about time?" And for them not to be like the people who were given the book previously, and they just had long hopes. The time passed them by, and their hearts became hardened. So he said, "The time has come for Al-Fudayl." His response was, "The time has come for Al-Fudayl." And he immediately went down and
saw. And
he went up a thief. And he came down a complete wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is mentioned as one of the top 40 of the awliya in the history of this ummah.
هارون الرشيد كان يسأل عنه يريد أن يقابله. هارون أمير المؤمنين.
The Khalifa or the leader of the believers, Harun al-Rashid, was seeking him and trying to find him to sit with him. But he just wants to meet him. Right, this is the king, and who does he want to meet? He wants to meet Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad. Al-Fudayl was running away from him, and he doesn't want to see him. So Al-Fudayl became Al-Fudayl. المرابط الحاجب
وخلت الأمة بخلفهم يعني خلاص
and the أمة is in their footsteps.
صار يقودان الأمة الإسلامية خلاص
and they began to lead the Muslim أمة.
مرابط الحاج وعجوبة الزمان وعجوبة هذا كعمر بن عبد الزمان كما قلت لكم عجيب.
The مرابط الحاج is a wonder of his age, that how on earth could somebody like that come about. It's a miracle, subhanAllah, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah, somebody can like that come
about. But
this was the story of his transformation.
درس طبعا مع أحمد النبات بعض العلوم ودرس مع أحمد ولاد علوم العربية كألفية ابن مالك بدقة. درس مع أحمد بن أبات هذا شيخه هذا الذي توفي عنده.
So he learned from Ahmad ibn Abbat.
شيخه الذي توفي.
Who passed away, who he gained.
الذي غير حياته.
Who changed his life. He learned many lessons and he studied with him for a while.
وقرأ مع المرابط أحمد فاد بن أد.
And he learned with also المرابط ابن أحمد فاد بن أد.
أحمد فاد. أحمد فاد هو بنفسه.
مرابط أحمد فاد بن أد.
الجكني. ودرس معه علوم العربية خصوصا ألفية ابن مالك وأتقنها جدا. درس معه علوم العربية.
He learned with him the sciences of Arabic and he mastered them.
ولم يقرأ المرابط الحاج من كتب العلم كثيرا إنما هي متون متفرقة من العلوم.
And he did not go in depth in a lot of topics, but he went and he learned many many different topics.
ما قرأ ما يقرأه موازله في ذلك الوقت. ما قرأ لا. No.
So he did not even study in depth half of what the people of his time were studying.
ولكن كما يقول عنه تلميذه الأول طبعا انتفع بهذين الشيخين وغيرهما ولكن هذين الشيخين ذكر أنهما نفعاه.
So then of course he benefited and he mentioned and
قال هذان الشيخين من وجدهما وتركهما فهو السفيه.
That he said that those two sheikhs of mine, whoever found them and abandoned them, that is a fool. That is a person who is missing out. That is a person who is deprived, who is cheated
himself.
And he said, I heard him say myself, he said, I was taking care of the flock, the sheep, the camels of Ahmed Fal ibn Addu, until my fingernails, my toenails started to fall off.
Then
my toenails fell off in the pursuit of taking care of the
camels.
Ahmed Zarruq? That Sidi Ahmed Zarruq, he said that go after. direct your attention and your focus towards serving your sheikh.
واعتقد واعتمد وثق بأن فضل الله فيه يستحق وثق.
And believe and be certain and confident that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help and goodness comes as a result of you serving your sheikh.
قرأ هذا ولكن حقيقة انتفع يقول بهذين الشيخين ولكن كما يقول شيخنا المرابط حدمي وهو أكبر تلامذته علما وسنا الآن وهو خليفته في الصلاة وفي الفتوى ولا زال على قيد الحياة وهو شيخ المحضرة الآن ومعه ابنه الشيخ عبد الرحمن وحبيبه عبد الله حفظ الله الجميع ونفعنا ببركاتهم يعني كما يقول مرابط الحاج الشيخ التقوى حقيقة.
So then of course Sheikh Murabit al-Hajj
درس مع هؤلاء شيء من العلم.
He learned with those two some knowledge, but as my Sheikh Sheikh Hadamin
حفظه الله تعالى
مرابط حدمين may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him. He is the oldest, the greatest in age and in knowledge of the remaining students of Murabit al-Hajj. And he was the one who took the place of Murabit al-Hajj in leading the school of Murabit al-Hajj. Before he even passed away, he was taking the responsibility of teaching there. And he is currently teaching over there despite his old age, barely, subhanAllah, may Allah preserve him and give him life and health. And he's teaching there now alongside the son of Murabit al-Hajj who just returned recently,
Sheikh Abdullah,
and also the other teacher over there is Sheikh Abdullah, the grandson of Sheikh Murabit al-Hajj. So that school in
Taganet
is still a capital and a qibla for knowledge. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it that virtue. We hope from Allah and we ask Allah, we beg from Allah to grant it that status until the Day of Judgment. In that, what did Hadamin say, Sheikh Hadamin, the Sheikh that we're mentioning? He said that the true
Sheikh,
the real Sheikh, the real teacher of Murabit al-Hajj is his taqwa.
وقد قالها في بعض أوقاته.
And he mentioned that several times.
كان أخي الفقيه، أخي الصغير اللي تعرف. كان
My younger brother and فقيه.
كان جالسا بجنبه.
He was sitting next to him one time.
فسمع قارئا يقول واتقوا الله ويعلمكم الله.
And he heard a reciter reciting the verse where Allah says and have taqwa of Allah and Allah will teach you.
فالمرابط الحاج انطلق من دور اختيار قال جربناها. جربناها.
So then subhanAllah just came out of مرابط الحاج without him intending. He said that He said, we experienced it.
جربناها سبحانه.
We experienced it.
فقط انطلق على لسانه.
That it just سبحانه came out of his tongue that we have experienced it. Have taqwa of Allah. Allah will teach you.
وطبعا هذا معروف هو المرابط الحاج عندما تنظر إلى معلوماته ليست من غزارة علم ليست من غزارة.
And سبحانه when you look at المرابط الحاج.
نحن شبابا صغارا. نترك من هو أعلم منه بكثير من بلاد موريتانيا.
And this is what we have seen as young men. That subhanAllah, the wisdom and the beauty and the depth and of his statements is not from an abundance of knowledge, subhanAllah. Rather, we saw from him, subhanAllah, beyond what we have seen from people who are far more knowledgeable, had studied far more books than him, and even some of his students had studied far more books than he ever studied.
سبحانAllah الرحيم العلامات عليه المنهج والتقوى لباس التقوى يعني شيء آخر.
The embodiment of that knowledge.
المنهجية والطريقة والهدوء والتطبيق هذا شيء.
The calm and the application, the manifestation of taqwa.
والزهد في الدنيا.
And زهد asceticism.
حتى قال لي بعض طلاب العلم قال عندما نرى العلماء أمام المرابط الحاج نعتقدهم أطفالا.
That subhanAllah, the scholars, they said this, that they told me that when we see the scholars sit in front of Murabit al-Hajj, it's like they're children in front of him. Great scholars as if they're children in front of him.
That
as if they're children that are looking at their father.
هذا المرابط آية من آيات الله سبحانه جل جلاله.
So المرابط الحاج
قدمنا عنه ترجمة إبان وفاته ولكن كنت نريد أن أخبر الناس بقصة تغيره حتى لعل الله تعالى أن ينفع بها الناس حتى لعل الله ينفع بها الناس.
So we had discussed one of the poems that was made about him.
ساعتين حتى عن حياته موته.
And about his life and about his passing.
وحصلت أيضا قصصا حول يانس قومي فرعوي
and also lessons about his poem that he would admonish himself with. But today we had intended to speak about his transformation.
Like كيف تغير؟
What made him who he was?
هذه الأمة كانت فيها الخير. هذه الأمة كانت فيها الخير.
This ummah had goodness in it.
كانت تفكر، كانت لها طباع قابلة للتغير.
That it was pondering, it was thinking, it had people were in such a state that they were willing to change.
عندما تسمع شيء تتغير، عندما تفهم شيء يخرج الله منها من يتغير. عند طباع قابلة.
That once they hear something, they're willing to change or to see some signs that okay, now I have to change.
نحن ترى بينا مع ناس كبار، حتى ناس كبار. أنا أتذكر جدتي وهي ابنة عم المرابط الحاج، جدتي من أمي وهي ابنة عمي. عندما تنظر في المرآة تقول السلام على وجهي بثناء والعدل. عندما تنظر في وجهها تقول سبحان الله. جدتي.
My grandmother, I've seen her, subhanAllah. And she's the cousin of Marabat al-Hajj.
من أمي.
My grandmother from my mother's side, she's the cousin of Marabat al-Hajj.
وكانت جميلة جدا في الشباب. كانت جميلة جدا.
She was very beautiful in her youth.
فكانت أنا كنت مع رأي وهي كبيرة في السن. عندما تنظر في المرآة تقول السلام على وجه الفناء والعدم.
And then she would, subhanAllah, in her old age, when she would look at the mirror, she would say, "Assalam to the face." Of fana and adam. Fana is annihilation, and adam is non-existence. Meaning that everything in the world changes, goes away.
في الثلاثينات وفي العشرينات ذات جمال والآن يعني كبيرة في السن يعني الوجه انطوى والعيون يعني تساقطت على الأجفان والشيب.
Annihilation means becoming nothing. That fading away.
كم كنت من الجمال والصحة.
That how much beauty did she have? And health and so on. And men were wishing to marry her and so on. Subhanallah, how everything becomes annihilated. Now she was like a walking funeral that she was taking
beatings.
So she was saying السلام to the face.
وكنت أتذكر أمي كذلك عندما ترى الشيبة في رأسها تقول سبحان الله يعني.
And my mother also, may Allah have mercy on her, would exclaim. Such things when she would see even gray hair. SubhanAllah, the warner has come to you. Take heed, though, take a lesson.
هذا صار حشيش. الربيع صار حشيشة. خلاص انتهى الأمر.
فهذا كان يعني ليس تأسفا عن
الدنيا. هذا موعظة بالتغير حياتي. الرحيل. أنا الرحيل. خلاص.
الناس يسمعون هذا
ويفهمون. أنا الرحيل. أنا الرحيل. خلاص انتهى.
This was not out of lamentation. Oh man, the good days are gone, or look, the world is going away from me.
أنا الرحيل. أنا الرحيل.
No, just a reminder that your time is coming.
إن الرحيل يا أخي قريب.
That just like your beauty went, you are leaving this world.
الرحيل الرحيل. وما نعمره ننكسه في الخلق فلا تعقلوا.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, and whoever we give them age, they get reversed. They go downhill. Do you not comprehend? Do you not understand?
رأيت كم من السنين مرت عليه وكم من شيء طلع في رأسك وكم من مشاكل مرت عليه وكم من صديق مات وكم من زوج مات.
SubhanAllah, you have seen how many of your friends...
تغيرات نفسية.
How many major changes have you seen? How many states have you changed? How many people close away?
وشيوخ.
And your teachers.
هذا ما تغيرت.
And you have not changed.
المرأة ما زالت تغير شكليتها تريد أن ترجع شاب.
No, the عملية. Woman is ignoring all of that and she's trying to make herself look youthful again.
والرجل ما زال يحلق اللحيه ويحلق حتى يكون صبيا أمرد.
And the man is just sculpting his beard just to make himself
يخاف الشيب
look
يظهر
like
على
a...
وجهه.
Or he's shaving his entire beard off, fearful that a gray hair would show.
ويسود الرأس.
And he dyes his hair black.
لكن هذه عجوز تمنت أن تكون فتية وقد يبس الجنبان وحدود بالله.
But this is an old lady who is trying to become a young woman, but while her
تعود إلى العطار يصلح شأنها.
While she has dried up.
وقد يبس الجنبان وحدود بالله قوس الله.
And her back has become hunched. And she's still going to get perfume and makeup and whatever to try to restore
her.
And is that a person who's selling these oils and perfumes? Is he going to fix what time has destroyed? Yeah, we'll do a plastic surgery, $100,000.
أقطعي جلدة من وجهك وجلدة من بطنك وجلدة من كتفك.
From your face. skin from your stomach, skin from your thigh. Yes, we'll do all that for you, but it's not going to bring you back in age. You're still an old lady. It's just a fabrication. It's fake. It's false.
ناس كانت قبائل عندما تنظر في تغيرات الأولياء كم كإبراهيم بن أدم حتى الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم كم تغيروا بمثل هذه القصص كم تغيروا حتى الصحابة
how many of even the companions they changed from these stories
ولذلك الدريدي يقول من لم تزد عبرا أيامه كان العمى أولى به من الهدى
and from the passing of time الدريدي he would say that whoever the passing of time just seeing this change take place all around that his days did not increase him in lessons
كان العمى أولى به من الهدى
fitting for him to be blind than to be guided.
من لم يعوه الدهر لم ينفعه ما راح به الواعظ يوما وغدا.
He said whoever is not doesn't benefit from is not admonished by the ages then no speaker will
كم من يموت منكم يوميا كم
will benefit him. How many of you die every single day?
وكم تفعلون الولائم بعده؟ ما زال طريحا على الجنازة على السرير.
You have subhanAllah the dead person is still not even buried yet.
ما زال في الثلاجة.
He's still in the freezer and you're having a party.
أنت تتقابل النساء كلها عليها ميك أب وويك أب والرجال حالقين لحام.
People go to the memorial. MashaAllah, the man has shaved his beard and so on, and he's laughing and smiling at the women who are coming with all their makeup and adorning themselves for such a gathering. What are you wearing? I'm wearing an Afghan clothes, Arab clothes. What car are you driving?
Mercedes.
Oh, I'm driving a Mercedes, of course. This is what people take away from death. That is death. The dead people are the ones who are coming.
تعزية عندما يأتون للزيارة هذه.
That now you're coming.
يركب واحد سيارة فخمة ويجعل معه أولاد وزوجته.
The people are coming for consolation for the dead person. All of those people need consolation for their death.
يأتي مع أولاد وأولاد ما هو ابنك مني دكتور.
The person is coming with his children and he's saying, "Oh, who's your son? Oh, my son's a doctor."
محامي
lawyer
مهندس
an engineer
هي بنتك
oh what's your daughter
انتهت الآن من شهادة الجامعة
oh she just got her degree
تبحث عن عمل
she's looking for a job
من هذا اللي أمامكم
who's this guy
هذه جنازة
oh this is a funeral this is a dead person
هذا هو صحيح هذا هو الواقع
is this true or not
هل هذا هو الواقع
is this what happens
yeah this is exactly what
happens هل هذا هو الواقع
Is this what happens?
الجنازة هناك في الثلاجة والناس تتحدث عن الشهادات وعلى الدكتورة. أنت ماذا تريد؟ أنا I want to marry. أنا أريد أن أتزوج.
The person is still in the freezer and the people are talking about these degrees and doctor and engineer and car and Mercedes.
Yeah, thank you very much. شكراً. شكراً جزيلاً. شكراً أيها الغافلون.
Thank you, oh heedless people.
الأموات في الثلاجات. وأنتم في الغفلات.
The people are the deceased people are in the fridge in the freezer and you're in heedlessness.
أمواج ماذا سمعتم صديقتي ماتت وصديقي مات وزوجي مات والشيخ الفلاني مات هل ستذهبون إلى الجماعة ترون نعم yes والله
That oh did you hear my friend died my husband died my wife died. Are you going to go to those people? Are you going to go and to their gathering? Oh yeah, to the memorial. Yes, we're going to see them. Where is the lesson that you're taking?
أنا لا أموت أنا لست من الميت أنا من المنظرين.
That no, I'm not going to die. I'm never going to die.
أنا من المنظرين.
I'm going to live forever.
أنا من المنظرين. هذا هو الحال. أنا من المنظرين. هو مات ولكن أنا من المنظرين.
He died. Yes.
هو ليس قياسا لنا. هو ليس قياسا.
No, I can't. There's no comparison. He's dead, but I'm a person who's living, and I'm going to continue.
No. مات ومات فلان. سبحان الله خلاص
انتهى. He died and she died. No problem, but I'm continuing.
أنا إن شاء الله الآن أنا غدا إن شاء الله سأبحث عن عمل في المكان الفلاني وشهادة في الجامعة الفلانية ومسافر إلى الصين وقابل فلان.
Tomorrow I'm going to get such a job and go for after such a degree, and I'm going to travel to China to meet someone.
تخطيطك ما هو؟
Long-term plans. What are your
plans?
What are your plans?
بعد 10 سنة إذا تزوج.
10 years, inshallah. After 10 years, I'm gonna get married.
بعد سنين بعد التجربة عليك سيكون عندي الأولاد.
After you know we have some fun together and some good times, then we'll think about having children.
من هذا اللي أمامك؟
Who is this in front of you?
هذا جنازة.
Oh, this is this guy, he's passed away.
كم عمره؟
How old is that person who passed away?
مثل عمري أو أصغر.
Oh, about my age or younger.
هذا واقع.
This is the reality, subhanAllah.
ما هو مات وانت ما زلت تخطط 10 سنين للدراسة بعد ذلك ستزوج بعد ذلك ستجرب الزوج.
Somebody who died who is your age and they're dead and you're saying oh 10 years I'll get married and then after that
سأخذ تجربة مع زوجتي.
We're going to spend some time with my wife before make sure we want to have kids and then we'll have kids after that.
هو مات ولكن نحن ما زلنا عمنا.
Subhanallah, that person died but you still have time.
ما كان يكرره شيخنا المراد الطحاوي رحمه الله تعالى اقتداء بالإمام البخاري كما كان عندما يأتي خبر أي أحد مات يقول إن عشت تفجع بالأحبة كلهم وفناء نفسك لا بالك أفجع مما جربناه من شيخنا اقتداء بالإمام البخاري
مراد الحاج he would mention And in accordance with what Imam al-Bukhari would mention when he would be informed of the death of someone. That he said, if you live, that you will be the opportunity to be surprised and shocked daily by the death of all of your loved ones, if you live long enough. And your own annihilation... is indeed more of a shock.
ناس تموت الليل والنهار وانت لا تفكر انك ستموت.
The longer you live, time after time after time, you're getting this shock, and your own shock is going to be greater. But people are dying, and you're not even taking a lesson.
لا تأخذ منهما أي موعظة. هم ينتقلون إلى القبور وأنت تنتقل القصور. ينتقلون إلى القبور وأنت إلى القصور. هيهات.
They're going to their graves, the قبور, and you're thinking you're going to the قصور, the castles, the palaces.
هذا هو الواقع.
This is the reality.
يذهبون بهم إلى القبور ويرجعون لهم القصور يشربون المقهى والخمور مع زوجاتهم وأولادهم. افتحوا التلفاز.
That you're going back to your big house and drinking coffee and drinking even alcohol with your family. And go turn on the TV.
ماذا وضعت من التوابل؟ ماذا وضعت من السوائل؟
What kind of food are you cooking? What kind of spices are you making?
أفغاني أو عربي؟ سوري سوري أو؟
What kind of cuisine is it? Arabic cuisine or Afghan cuisine?
Yes, my husband. Food ready. الطعام موجود.
Oh yes, my husband. The food's ready.
Thank you, my wife. هذه أمة الطعام. هي أمة الغفلة والطعام. هذه أمة الغفلة والطعام. شكرا زوجتي الفاسدة شكرا زوجي الفاسد
Thank you my corrupt wife Thank you my corrupt husband
Thank you شكرا يا أولادي الفاسدين شكرا يا أباء المفسدين
Thank you for my corrupt children and thank you for my parents who are corrupting me
جزاكم الله خيرا أمة الطعام والغفلة
Thank you O أمة of food and heedlessness
تدفنون الأموات وترجعون إلى الغفلات
Right, as opposed, of course, people, if you didn't realize, as opposed to Murabit al-Hajj's awakening from death, people, unfortunately, they're surrounded by death, and they're leaving.
Ya Murabit, qala lahum al-dunya la tusawi shayn. Ahmed ibn Abbat, ala rusukhihi fi al-ilmi wa ishtiharihi.
Murabit al-Hajj will tell the people, this world is worth nothing.
Ahmed ibn Abbat, ala rusukhihi fi al-ilmi.
That he said that, subhanAllah, despite his great knowledge and status, that Shaykh Ahmed ibn Abbat, he passed away. If there was anyone who was deserving to stay in this world, it would have been him.
يموت أولادنا وزوجاتنا وأصدقائنا ما نتأثر نزداد غفلة على غفلة.
But our own families pass away, our husbands, our wife, our mother, our father.
كل العالم يموت ليلا ونهارا على طبقاته.
The whole world is dying. All types of people around us are dying day and night.
ولكن نحن لا نزداد إلا غفلة وبعدا عن الله تعالى.
But we only increase in heedlessness and distance from.
لا تغيرون الحوادث. لا تغيرون الحوادث.
Nothing changes us. Nothing.
الصالحون تغيرهم المرائي ونحن تزيدون المصائب فسادا.
The righteous people are changed by something as a dream, a true dream will change a righteous person, but calamities are surrounding us and we're only increasing in
heedlessness.
Death is only increasing us in
heedlessness. قد ذكرت كثيرا من حياة شيخنا رحمه الله تعالى فلا نطيل بها إبان موته يوم موته رحمه الله تعالى قبل سنتين وذكرت أيضا بعض حياته في كلامي عن يا نفس قومي فرعوي وانزجري وأسأل الله بجاه الكريم أن يرزق أهله التوفيق والعافية وينشر ذلك العلم من ذلك البلد إلى يوم الدين وينفعنا ببركاته وبركات أسلافنا الصالحين وإن كانت عائلته من أسلافنا والحمد لله تعالى.
And I mentioned many virtues and stories about our Sheikh Marabit al-Hajj, not just now, but go back and look at when he passed away a couple of years ago and then a year after his passing. As well, other things that we mentioned in regard to his story and his admonishment of himself and the lessons we learned from him. But I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us all to benefit from his blessings and to follow in his footsteps and to bless him and protect him and all of us. To connect those blessings to us and benefit us from his blessings. And to bless us with following his footsteps.
اللهم آمين يا رب العالمين اللهم آمين يا رب العالمين اللهم آمين يا رب العالمين ولا زال أبناء شيخي بعزة وكلهم لا زال كالعالم الفردي وإن الذي يخفي ضميري عنكم من الحب والتقدير أضعاف ما يبدي ولا زال أبناء شيخي بعزة ولا زال آل شيخي بعزة وكلهم لا زال كالعلم الفردي وإن الذي يخفي ضميري عنكم من الحب والتقدير أضعاف ما يبدي اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد جزاهم الله عنا خير جزاهم الله عنا جزاهم الله عنا خيرا جزاهم الله عنا خيرا الشاعر يقول بلاد خص الله بالحاج مكرما والأرض كما في المهل تشقى وتسعد بلاد يغيب إليها كل جاهل ويرجع ملآنا من العلم لتلد بلاد خص الله بالحاج مكرما والأرض كما في المثل تشقى وتسعد بلاد يغيب إليها كل جاهل ويرجع ملآنا من العلم لتلد ويقول الآخر فكم جود الآيات فيك مجود تكاد الجبال الصم منه تفطر سلالة أشياخ كرام أجلة سبيلهم هو السبيل المنور تأتي القوافل لو شط المزار بها حيث الشروق وحيث الشمس قد غربت كم عصبة ضربت في الأرض ذاهبة للشيخ واستكملت علما به انقلبت كم من ألوف ركاب حط سايسها للعلم طالبة نكبادها ضربت كم ليلة بات شيخ المشايخ في سهرة بكتاب الله قد عذوبت يا من تحاول حصرا للخصال به دع ذال عمري فتلك حالة صعوبت عد النجوم وعد للحصى عبث هل عالج رمله من قبل قد حسبت شيخ المشايخ هذه الناس قبل بعدكم ماجت ومادت بقطع الهول واغتطفت يا أيها الشهداء ما الرأي عندكم بشيخنا عند قول المصطفى وجبت من أثنيتم عليه خيرا وجبت له الجنة ومن أثنيتم عليه شرا وجبت له النار اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد بذكر الصالحين تتنزل الرحمة بذكر الصالحين تتنزل الرحمة بذكر الصالحين تتنزل الرحمة بذكر الصالحين تتنزل الرحمة ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. يا من وفقت أهل الخير للخير وأعنتهم عليه وفقنا على الخير وأعنا عليه. يا من وفقت أهل الخير للخير وأعنتهم عليه وفقنا على الخير وأعنا عليه. يا من وفقت أهل الخير للخير وأعنتهم عليه وفقنا على الخير وأعنا عليه. يا ربي يا من وفقت أهل الخير للخير وأعنتهم عليه وفقنا الخير وأعنا عليه. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم المهتدون. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم المهتدون. الحمد لله الذي بنعمته وجلاله تتم الصالحات، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أشرف المخلوقات، وعلى آله وأصحابه أصحاب المقامات. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، والسلام على المرسلين.